really an incredible sight. Huge container ship was stuck really tight. The other ships behind it, they were repaired. With no idea how long that ship would be there. Grounded for the world to see. Several days and nights in a jam, stuck in the Suez Canal. Yeah, stuck in the Suez Canal. Guess it must have been quite dull for the crew. Were they thinking that their captain's a dope? Should have gone around the Cape of Good Hope. Evergiven all at sea. World trade in a plight. Traffic jam stuck in the Suez Canal. This huge stuff up from China was sailing up to Rotterdam. With the cute ships behind me, wishing past that ship they could please, please. Now at last the Evergiven is free. Now the owners want an inquiry. Was it all down to a human mistake? While the world goes on for you know what's sake. Worst things can occur at sea. Ship stuck in the night like a dam stuck in the Suez Canal. Stuck in the Suez Canal.
Good evening and welcome to the Hughes at 10 with me, the Gorgeous Huw Ewdards. I'm too sexy for my shirt. The headlines. The teacher suspended for showing pupils a cartoon of the Prophet Muhammad has said that he didn't realise it was a state school and therefore non-profit. Following a row over David Cameron's dealings with a banker, Cabinet Minister Oliver Dowden has defended the former Prime Minister, describing him as, quote, a man of the utmost integrity, unquote. Mr. Dowden went on to describe Theresa May as a wild, crazy, fun-loving party animal and Boris Johnson as a completely loyal and faithful husband. A dinosaur similar to the T-Rex has been discovered in Argentina and given the menacing name, the one who causes fear. Paleontologists are said to be thrilled at the discovery of the pretty Patellosaurus. Okay, everyone, I would just like to reassure everyone that despite what's been happening in the EU with the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccine, it is completely safe. In fact, I've just had it myself. Yes.
Any comment about the clots, Prime Minister?
Yes, I'll be meeting them all later on, as usual, in the Cabinet meeting. Yes. Hello, and welcome to the Alex Salmon Show, with me, Alex Salmon, the pride of Scotland, Scotland's greatest national treasure. And today, on the Alex Salmon Show, I'm joined by the pride of Scotland, Scotland's greatest national treasure, none other than the great Alex Salmon. Hello, Alex. Hello, Alex. And may I say what a great honour it is for you to have me, the great Alex Salmon, as a guest on your show. It certainly is. And of course, it's a very great honour for you to be interviewed by me, the great, great Alex Salmon. Well, of course. Now, Alex, after your recent feud with that totally unreasonable and obviously deranged harpy Nicola Sturgeon, you've now set up your own political party. That's right, Alex. After my feud with that totally and utterly unreasonable and obviously totally, utterly, completely deranged harpy Nicola Sturgeon, I have indeed set up my own political party, the Alibar Party. That's wonderful, Alex. And of course, Alibar is the old Gaelic word for Scotland. Only someone as brilliant as yourself could have come up with such a marvellous name. That's right. Only someone as astonishingly and magnificently brilliant as myself could have come up with such a marvellous, stupendous name. Far, far better than the boring old Scottish National Party, led by that totally, utterly and completely deranged harpy, Nicola Sturgeon. And by the way, at the risk of appearing immodest, Alibar also stands for Alex loves being Alex. A-L-B-A. That's right. I did think that myself, of course, but modesty prevented me from mentioning that ALBA does indeed stand for Alex loves being Alex. It certainly does. So, finally, Alex, with your new Alex Loves Being Alex party, you're hoping to achieve a super majority for Scottish independence. That's right, Alex, not just an ordinary majority like the morning SNP, led by that totally, utterly and completely deranged harpy, Nicola Sturgeon, but a super majority. Wonderful. Only someone as marvellous as yourself could have come up with such a completely original idea, adding the word super before the word majority. That really is quality thinking of the highest order. Alexander Graham Bell, John Logie Baird, and even Einstein himself would have been filled with admiration. They certainly would have been. Well, Alex, it's been an absolute pleasure having you, the great Alex Salmond, as a guest on The Alex Salmond Show. There's really no one I'd rather spend time with. Right back at you, Alex. Good night. Your anti-vax. It's been such a busy week with so many letters. I don't know how the government is able to open and read them all before they get to me. Anyway, time for our first letter. Dear anti-vax, my husband saw on the news something about a gigantic asteroid called Apophis. Oh, I've heard about that. Anyway, he said it's going to hit the Earth and wipe out life as we know it. I tried to tell him that NASA says it's not going to hit the planet, but he won't listen. Please tell him we're not all going to die. Yours, end of my tether in tether's end. Well, my goodness, what an interesting situation. Well, Mr. Tether, I can assure you that the asteroid Apophis will not hit the Earth as predicted. Scientists say it'll pass by like a great big shooting star, which is a bit of a disappointment, to be honest. Because, you see, just like you, I thought a planet-wide extinction event was on the horizon. So my lockdown project has been building and filling my survival shelter in my garden. Now what? Got a great big bloody hole filled with 200 bottles of Prosecco and a chemical toilet. I took up the peonies for nothing. Ridiculous. To mark the anniversary of the first coronavirus lockdown, a series of especially organised commemorative events all over the country have been cancelled. In the wake of the coronavirus, European leaders have called for a treaty similar to the one made after World War II. The French government want closer cooperation, the Germans want a more organised union, and the British government want to pay nurses the wages of the 1940s.
No injectoria, no je m'injecteria, je reject, les inject, AstraZeneca, Pfizer, BioNTech, no, no pour moi le vaccin, no, je reject le vaccin. In my veins, I'll be fine. Only accept Chanel numero 5. Novavax, Sinovac. Ni pour moi, non, c'est vax. Keep those vaccines away. I want one that's français. But you know, actually, I might trust but Nick V. So it's Russian, so what? It's not British, that's what. No, le vaccin anglais. No, au revoir les anglais. Ni pour moi, ni pour vous. Nil by mouth. Don't call me, I'll call you. Je suis le président de France. just say no.
Good evening and welcome to Fox News with me, Ann Anchor. Trouble in the land of Scotty Dogs as former President Alex Salmond has created a new independence party attempting to overthrow Her Majesty Nicola Sturgeon. Over to our foreign correspondent, Chad Vallée, with all the latest on the Alba Party.
Thanks, Ann, although it's actually pronounced Alaba.
Is that because it's Gaelic, Chad?
Close, Ann. As we are in Scottishire, it would be Gaelic. They don't pronounce the E.
So they don't pronounce the E's when they are there and sound A's when they aren't?
That's right, Anne. For example, how would you pronounce this girl's name on your screen?
Oh. Siobhan?
No, Anne, that's Siobhan. How about this one?
Sinhead?
No, that's Sinead. How about this one, Anne?
K.O. me?
No, that's Weaver. And lastly...
Wait a minute, Chad. I got this one. Is it Boo Rise?
No, Anne. Everyone around here pronounces it scumbag.
So, Chad, why is Gaelic so complicated?
Well, and our researchers think it's a ploy to catch out the arrogant people of Englandshire when writing Christmas cards to their Scottish and Irish neighbours. Well, that's it for me, Anne. I'm off to grab a traditional Scottish dessert.
A deep-fried Mars bar, Chad?
No, a peach Malabar, followed by a rum and Raisin ice cream.
Okay, that was Chad Vallée developing diabetes, or is that diabetes? You've been watching Fox News, and I've been Jennifer Curie's lookalike. Good night.
Ah, aha. Good evening.
Evening. Can I see your COVID passport, please?
Oh, yes, certainly. There you go.
Oh, dear. One of those red ones, is it?
Well, yes. Is that a problem?
Only blue passports in here, I'm afraid. This is the blue ball, sir. I can see that you are a regular at the Red Lion.
Well, I've been there a few times, but oh, surely it doesn't matter.
Funny cuisine in the Red Lion, I'm afraid. Foreign, see?
Well, that's why I came here, see? Pie, chips and a pint, you know, just for change.
Well, I'm allowed to use my discretion.
Oh, good. After all, this is nothing to do with COVID, is it? It's just because, you know, I've got a different coloured passport. After all, I do have my mask. Look, see?
We take our precautions very seriously here, sir. Hand sanitising, social distancing. None of us want to stand next to someone suspect, do we?
Well, of course. No, I didn't mean to.
Take off your shoes, your belt, place your mobile, loose change and any metallic objects in the tray.
What?
Rules is rules. And you do have a funny coloured passport. When you're ready, we'll ask you to step through the scanner while we x-ray your belongings. With a blue one, see, you could have gone straight through.
This is ridiculous.
Anything to declare? Cold symptoms, fever, funny rash, membership of the Conservative Club down the road?
Of course not.
No one joining you later?
Well, the wife was just parking up and getting the baby out of the car. I just came ahead to order.
Right, well, I'm going to need you to fill in this form then. It's a customs form.
What customs?
Our customs, sir. So, do you... or your wife or baby play any of the following? Cribbage, dominoes, darts or skittles?
No.
Typical Red Lion clientele and their funny foreign ways, in my opinion.
But I'm British, born and bred.
That's what they all say. But you never even played pool, have you?
Well, no.
Drink German beer, do you, sir?
Stella Artois, actually.
It's even worse. You're not really helping your asylum application.
Asylum? Look, I just want pie, chips and a...
and a pint of continental slops. Yeah, I heard you the first time.
Oh, this is ridiculous.
You're all the same, you lot. You think you can just pop in here, stock up on your duty free, then bog off back down the Red Lion, don't you, eh? Fill out this VAT form. You could try and claim it back on the way out. Well, I wouldn't hold my breath if I were you.
I'm not standing for this. I'm off to the Green Man.
La-di-da. Dual drinking nationality, are we? Oh, got a green passport too, have you? Well, all right then, go on, bug off. Go on, drink your Guinness then.
Fine.
Don't want your lot in here.
The Pope, the Archbishop of Canterbury and the Chief Rabbi were barred from entering a pub this week after the landlord thought they were taking the mickey. None of these Scottish political parties have released a manifesto yet, despite the parliamentary elections being next month. The Greens want the SNP to release one first, so they know what they're for. The Labour Party wanted to know what they're against. And the Tories wanted so they can have something to read on the way back to England.
Time for our next letter. Now, it's come from overseas. Oh, but it's not a globalist. Anyway. Dear anti-vax, I am becoming increasingly stressed about the growth of the anti-vax movement in my country. Ooh. Oh, especially with AstraZeneca. Oh, I thought it was about me. Anyway, we are now one of the world's most vaccine-sceptic countries in the world, and there's misinformation everywhere. I have tried banning it, bringing it back, and banning it again, but now I'm out of ideas. Please help. Yours, Macron. Macron? Oof. Well, that's a funny name. I don't know where it's from. Oh, it smells French to me. Oh, well, I'm not sure about this. Oh, it's definitely French. But he's not said where he's from, so it's just a guess for now. Anyway, I don't think we'll bother with any of that. Anyway, loves. Well, that's all from me now, loves. So don't forget to send me all your queries and your concerns in your letters, although we might be keeping an eye out for some of those foreign postmarks from now on. Bye!
Right, before we start, do you want a kotok?
A what?
A cup of tea or coffee?
No, I'm fine, thanks.
Right, I'll ask them to start the DIR.
The what?
It's the digital interview recorder.
Oh.
Right, AC12 interview, present DSTJ and DCIKD. Right, DCIKD. I understand you've been investigating a CAID.
A CAID?
A CAID, yeah. CAID. It's an abbreviation for criminal activity in drugs. Really, DCIKD, do you not know your PAAs?
PAAs?
Police acronyms and abbreviations.
Oh, right. No, sorry. See, I suffer from FOMA.
FOMA?
Fear of misusing acronyms.
OMG.
OMG?
Oh, my God. Look, how can you work in SCG and not know your PAAs?
SCG? Oh, right, yeah. Serious Crime Group. I was wondering what that meant. Yeah, SCG. God, that explains a lot.
Hello, hello, hello. What's going on here then?
What's that an abbreviation for?
Don't know that one.
Do you know, sir?
You don't know what L-O-L-O-L-O means?
Do you know what? I've got no idea.
Support is growing for defunding the police after revelations that they haven't had a decent song since Walking on the Moon. Well, that's about all we've got time for tonight. I'll be back later on BBC Hugh with the Hughes Night. And don't forget to join me tomorrow when I'll be presenting a very special evening, an evening dedicated to me, the gorgeous Huw Ewdards. And why not? So, for the Huw Ewdards theme night, it starts with Huw-a-vision Song Contest, which Wales, of course, are bound to win, followed by Who Do You Think You Are at 7. Then, at 8 o'clock, we see what's cooking in the big tent at the Great British Huw Off. And then we hand over to BBC Huw for Huw Ewdards, Huw Ewdards and Huw Ewdards as they take a sideways swipe at the news in Have I Got Hughes For You. Well, at 10, it's a piece of classic comedy as Huw Ewdards and Huw Ewdards, of course, present a packed programme and give a masterclass in timing in the two Hueys. Until then, it's good night from me. And it's good night from you. Good night.
funny, right?
Oh!
Blodwyn, I wouldn't come over the phone with you. There's a Dalek.
Doctor, we have a proposition for you. How would you like to come and work for us at GB News?
Never. I'm the gorgeous Dr. Huw. And I will never, ever leave the BBC, no matter how much they traduce my Welsh patriotism.
Fair enough. We'll just ask Simon McCoy. He'll do any old rubbish.
Oh.
Racial Commission, what have you done? Racial Commission, you got it all wrong. Everyone knows that whites are all the same. Everyone knows that they are all to blame. All of them racists. Your report don't say the same. So I say it's a whitewashing. 'Cause I don't like what it contains. Racial Commission, I read your report. Racial Commission, here is how it told. Everyone knows no whites are all the same. Everyone knows immigrants are all to blame. Send them all back. Your report don't say the same. The far right say it's white bashing. But no one likes what it can say. Nice day for a whitewashing. It's a nice day for a whitewashing.